Regarding the Emirates operations in Nigeria, once again we have a problem with them. For those who are intending to go to UAE at the moment via Emirates, I think it's very important that they understand what is going on, and so that they don't see it from, they see it from the perspective that we've seen it. So there is what is called bilateral air service agreement. These are agreements between countries on how to operate or how the airlines will operate in each other's territory. In this case, how will Emirates airline operate within the shores of Nigeria, and how will any Nigerian airline operate within the shores of UAE? So they've got two major airlines, that is the Etihad and the Emirates. So we negotiated a bilateral air service agreement with them when we came in as a government, and we gave them the requested 21 frequencies, meaning that they will be coming to Nigeria 21 times in a week, or simplified as 3 times a day, 2 in Lagos, 1 in Abuja. They were having just 14 frequencies when we came, and it was 7 for Lagos, 7 for Abuja. They never operated the Abuja until when we came. So anyways, they have 21 frequencies. They come to Abuja once and Lagos twice every day before the embargo. We have no airline that can go 21 times into UAE. So they are taking advantage of us, which is our fault, not theirs. But however, we've got an airline, Nigerian airline, which is Airpeace, that applied to get only 3 out of the 21 frequencies, and I approved. So Airpeace wanted to be going into UAE 3 times in a week. So UAE refused to approve the 3 frequency for Airpeace. They insisted on giving them only one frequency, and it's in Sharjah. Now, we are giving them 21 from our agreement. They ought to give us 21. So what they're supposed to do is to give Airpeace 21. And then Airpeace is up to Airpeace to operate all the 21 or operate just their 3. So we went back and forth with them. Right here in Colombia, they're here. We have a meeting with them. And we said, okay, well, we are going to also go and look at it and give you also one frequency, as against 21. So they wrote us a letter, very insulting letter, that referring to our meeting, discussions and agreement, blah, 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 in accordance with the bilateral air service agreement between the two countries, and having looked at our operations with great pain, we're giving you or Airpeace one slot in Sharjah. And that is the best we can do in the circumstance that our airports are full. So this is very insulting, and this is not acceptable by international treaty, convention or agreement. And therefore, I directed that they also be given one frequency and into Abuja. So whoever, and beginning from the 12th, so from 13th, they will only come once into the country. So anybody who wants to get out using Emirates should get out on the 12th maximum. And then when he wants to return, he should book his returning. And he should make sure that that return date is on a Thursday, and he's coming to Abuja, and get his booking confirmed. I know they cannot bear the pressure because they've lost a lot of money in the past. Honestly, who cares? But by they are not coming, they are losing a lot of money. We also in Nigeria are losing the service they provide. We're also losing some economic activity as a result of their coming. But the sovereignty of 200 million people is too important for us to toy with. So on behalf of the 200 million Nigerians, I've taken the decision that they also be given one slot, simpliciter. And this is just for your information. And there's nothing grandstanding. It's just the way things are in civil aviation. And with all sense of modesty, I've been in the industry for 37 years now. And because we stood our ground, that's why, for those 8 months, that's why they came back and obeyed what Nigeria had agreed with them up initio. And now they're coming from this this side. Then also there's the case of Saudi Arabia, who put Nigeria on a ban list, no visa, no travel, etc. So also Canada. So today there was a meeting which I participated in, Zoom meeting from the COVID-19 task force. Just for your information also, we've given our input as aviation that is not acceptable by us. And we recommend that those countries, Canada, UK, Saudi Arabia, and Argentina, be also put on red list. Just the, like similar they did to us. And if they don't allow our citizens to go into their country, so who are they coming as airline to pick out of a country? You know? So they might as well stop coming. So I'm very sure in the next 3 days, between now and Monday, or perhaps Tuesday maximum, all those countries will be put on red list from the PSC, from the task force of COVID-19. And once they are put on red list, which means they are banned, then of course the airline would also be banned. So I'm so sorry, we are going through a difficult moment, but we have to do it in the interest of our country.